Now, regarding the normal structures that are lying in the spine, are basically over here. You can see these are the afferent sensory nerves over here. Then we have efferent signals that are coming from over here, and this is basically the spinal column. The inner surface is basically the gray matter which lies over here. Just to have an overview and just to revise all the anatomy in your minds, you have to go through this, and it's very helpful just to know what kind of trauma these spines can go through and what are the results for that trauma. So here we have the gray matter, then we have the white matter over here. Over here in this diagram, you can see the spinal nerves that are on this side, and then we have the dorsal root column, which is basically lying on the lateral surfaces of the spinal cord. And then over here, we have the anterior median fissure, which is basically carrying all these arteries and veins. So basically, these nerves, these arteries and veins, and this gray and white matter, all of them are at stake whenever there is a trauma to the spine. So this is basically the mainstay to that, and the cervical part is most important. Why is it so important? Because it is the part that will go through that hyperextension and hyperflexion that I was talking about. So it's basically the most important and the most vulnerable portion that can go through this trauma. It is caused by the compressional hyperflexion and the hyperextension stress that we'll go through.